2 days ago, I was before the Honorable Rika, the judge for Labor and Employment Court, and he had me ex parte, and he set his ruling for today, this morning, and he has delivered his ruling. In the ruling, he has said that he needs slightly more information for him to address the prayers I've made, and he has directed that I serve the Kenya Ports Authority, I serve the Honorable Attorney General, I serve Mrs. Catherine Mturi-Wairi, I serve Dr. Manduku, so that they can reply within 14 days, and within those days, they can also put in the papers he requires, because he says he would like to see the resolutions of the board. He would like to see the people who sat at that board, because we do not have the evidence. And he would like to see the employment contract of the substantive MD, Catherine Wairi, and the employment contract of the acting MD, or the purportedly acting MD. And he also told me I need to put in a further affidavit on those grounds, bringing those documents before the court. If not, the other party bring them before the court. He has agreed with the issues of law that I've raised. He has agreed that the matter raises substantive issues of law, but he has declined to grant conservator orders on basis of the points of law only. He wants material facts to be before him. So I'm going to endeavor and see that I present those papers to the court. And from here, I'm going to write a letter to the management of the Kenya Ports Authority, requesting them to disclose, make full disclosure of that material that the judge wants. We are not going to resort to self-help at this stage, although self-help is possible, so that we can bring the material before the court and give the court a chance to make a reasoned ruling. This particular case is not a sprint. It's a marathon. Because the vested interests are deep, you are dealing with cartels,